We are internally related to everything, yes. Not externally related. Consciousness is an internal relationship to the whole. We take in the whole and we act toward the whole. And yeah. That internal, whatever we have taken in, determines basically what we are.
Well, you see, I think the difficulty is this fragmentation, first of all. Everybody is, all thought is broken up into bits, like this nation, this country, this industry, this profession, and so on, and they can't meet. And it's extremely hard to break into that. Therefore, people cannot see that they are creating a problem and then apparently trying to solve it. That is, see, let's take the problem, what problem do you like, pollution, or the ecology. See, the ecology is not in itself a problem. It works perfectly well by itself. It's due to us, right? It's a problem because we are thinking in a certain way by breaking everything up and each person is doing his own thing, right? Now, therefore, the ecological problem is due to thought, right? But thought thinks it is a problem out there and I must solve it. Now, that doesn't make sense because simultaneously thought is doing all the activities which make the problem and then does another set of activities to try to overcome it. You see, it doesn't stop doing the things which are making the ecological problem or the national problem or whatever the problem is. The earth is one household, really.
Yeah.
We're not treating it that way, right? So that's the first step in economics, is to say the earth is one household and all that it depends on. It's all one, you see. So now the implicate order would help us to see that, to see everything enfolds everything. Everybody not merely depends on everybody, but actually everybody is everybody in a deeper sense.
The root of the word compassion, you see, to feel together. And if people feel, have the same feeling together, are responsible for each other, then you have compassion.
And you don't think it's part of, what's the word, original sin, that human beings in their very nature compete?
Well, I don't think that there is such thing as original sin, and I think it has developed more and more with the growth of our society, that there's no evidence that people in the hunter-gatherer society were all that competitive. But the more you made society big and you had organization and you had to get to the top, the people on the bottom would suffer. There was a drive to compete, naturally.
This wholeness, this new consciousness, this wholeness, is that something that you can only glimpse?
Not really complete. The wholeness is an attitude or an approach, but it can be given a scientific realization, you see. Because of relativity and quantum theory, we can, if we wish, look on the world as a whole. But I think science has begun to replace religion as the major source of the worldview. Therefore, if science takes a fragmentary worldview, it will have a profound effect on consciousness.
And if we have coherence, in what way will our behavior be seen to be different?
We will produce the results we intend rather than the results we don't intend. That's the first big change. Then we will be more orderly, harmonious, you know, we will be happier. I think we could put all that in there. But the greater power we have, the greater we need coherence. The question to my mind is the human being capable of dealing with this situation, which he himself has produced?